Dear friends, greetings to all. Today's topic is methods of measuring dispersion. This is in the 7th chapter named Measures of Dispersion of the subject Business Statistics. Now let us study about the different methods of measuring dispersion. There are 5 different methods available. First one is range. Second one is mean deviation. Third one is quartile deviation. Fourth one is standard deviation. Fifth one is Lorentz curve. Okay. Let us study these 5 very brief, and it's only this matter only available. Now that first one is the range. Range is the difference between the highest value and lowest value of the data, of the mass data or group of data or variables. Suppose the income in a locality is from lowest 5,000 per month, highest suppose 35,000. Then the range is 35,000 minus 5,000 equal to 30,000. Okay, average may be somewhat different. Range is 30,000. The coefficient of range can be measured as, that is, the difference between largest value and smallest value divided by sum of the largest value and smallest value. In the example, that is 35,000 minus 5,000 divided by 35,000 plus 5,000. That means 30,000 divided by 40,000. That will be coefficient, means less than 1. Here only 0.75 in this example. Okay, very simple for calculation. One has to identify the lowest value and highest value, or largest value and smallest value. Then second one is mean deviation. Mean deviation is the ratio between the sum of deviations taken from mean and the total number. That is sigma modulus d divided by n. Modulus d means that there should not be any, minus value. So that average may be suppose 70 and one variable is 60, means then 60 minus 70 is minus 10. But minus should not be taken, it should be taken as positive 10 only. That is modulus difference. Modulus difference means that. And then suppose that one average is 70, then the particular variable is 90, means then that 90 minus 70, that is positive quotient 20. So then sum will be, you will be getting sum. Otherwise the sum will be 0. Sum of the deviations taken from arithmetic mean, if minus value is applied, then it will be giving 0. So modulus d you have to take, eliminate the minus, and then you will be getting that value sum, and that will be divided by n. Then that is called the mean deviation. Okay, coefficient of mean deviation means mean deviation divided by arithmetic mean. Mean deviation divided by arithmetic mean. Then you will be getting a value less than 1. Coefficient definitely will give less than 1 value, that its character is either minus or plus. Here it is plus only. We are not considering the minus value. Okay. Then third one is quartile deviation. You know that quartiles, three quartiles are available. First quartile, 1/4. Second quartile, 2/4 or 1/2. That is median. Third quartile, 3/4. And this is identified as Q1, Q2, Q3. Here we are taking first quartile and third quartile for the measurement of the quartile deviation. Quartile deviation is the average between sum of first quartile and third quartile. That is Q3 plus Q1 by 2. Q3 plus Q1 by 2 is the value of quartile deviation. Then coefficient of quartile deviation can be calculated as Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1. Only two quartiles we are taking into account, third and first. So coefficient means in the numerator you should differentiate and denominator you should add Q3 minus Q1 by Q3 plus Q1. Okay. Then that the fourth one is the standard deviation. This is the important measures of the dispersion, most commonly applied for the further research, further analysis of the data. Mean and standard deviation are usually taken for many kind of analysis. I mean, I squared test, so many test hypothesis testing can be conducted. Then how it is measured? It is the the square root of the sum of squares from the arithmetic mean. Correctly, one has to express means it is the mean sum of squares. Mean sum of squares, square root of mean sum of squares taken from arithmetic mean. Okay, that can be square root of sigma x minus x bar square by n. That is sigma x means variable minus x bar average square. Sigma, that square individual value of x minus x bar should be calculated and the square should be taken. That may be minus n plus will be there. And square means automatically it will become positive and the sum you are going to take and then that sum divided by the total number, say 100 number means that divided by 100, then you have to make it square root, then you will be getting the standard deviation. That will not be in, not less than 1, need not be less than 1, it would be more than. So that average may be, 74. The standard deviation means 12 or maybe 24 or 5. 5 is means that degree of dispersion or scatter is very low. If it is 24 and average is 74, then scatter is more. Through this measure, we can easily identify to what extent it is deviated. What is a degree of deviation can be easily identified. Then last one, fifth one is Lorentz curve. This is a graphical method for determining the degree of dispersion. Graphical method. The Lorentz mathematician has developed this. In this method, that x bar should represent the variable, x axis will represent variable, y axis represents cumulative frequencies. Frequency value should be cumulated and cumulated value, I mean, should be represented in y-axis, and corresponding to x, the cumulative value should be, I mean, identified. Thereby, a graph should be determined that may give us some curve. Through that, we can find out to what extent it is. It is going straight means then low degree, much deviation, much. I mean, it is taking much different shape means then much deviation is there. Okay, this is these are all the different measures of dispersion. Then I think I can present this through the illustrations and make it very clear about this chapter dispersion, so that everyone can very easily be able to study this particular, I mean, topic. Not only the particular topic, all the, I mean, chapters in the business studies can be studied very easily when you are, I mean, viewing this video many times, one or two times. It's enough for you. Okay, thank you very much.